Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Essay, and I'm back on another video. And today I have the intriguing band Sade. Contrary to popular belief, Sade is a band, not just one person. Sade just happens to be the front woman and the face of the band. So with that being said, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment, and let's get right into it. The band Sade is very mystique and mysterious. Their sound is like no other, with them being one of the first band in the Quiet Storm era, starting in 1982 in London, England. I will be giving acknowledgement to the band, but I will also be focusing on Sade, the lead singer herself, how she came up, and how the band was formed. Paul Denman, born on July 29, 1957. He is a songwriter and the bassist. He is from Hull, England, and he joined the band in 1982. Stuart Matthewman, born on August 18, 1960. He is the songwriter, producer, and a saxophonist. He is from Hull, England, and he joined the band in 1982. Andrew Hale, born on December 7, 1962. He is a keyboardist and composer. He is from London, England as well, and he joined the band in 1983. Former member Paul Cook, he was born on December 18, 1961 in Hull, England, and he was the drummist from 1982 to 1984. We have Sade Adu, our lead singer, who is very mysterious, the face of the band, the main character.
You have to not be scared to go away. Obviously, I think a lot of people are frightened that if they go away, if they disappear for a while, everything will crumble. They'll come back and there's no place for them. I think the break, actually, being away, was good for us all, you know, because it gives you a chance to realise why you're doing what you do and actually want to do what you do. Not just do it because you're already there and you're on the roll.
Helen Felashade Adu was born on January 16, 1959. Sade was born in Ibadan, Nigeria. With her middle name, Felashade, meaning crowned with wealth, in Yoruba, she was bound for greatness.
My name is, my true Nigerian name, or the true Nigerian pronunciation, or as close as I can get to it, is Fola Sade, which means crowning glory. And it was abbreviated. I could have been actually called Fola, which is like a prefix, which is like quite a common prefix, in fact. Or I could have been called Sade, and I was called Sade. Sade, really. But in England, everybody goes Sade. In America, people tend to go Sade.
Her mother, Annie Hayes, is an English district nurse. Her father, Adebasi Adu, was a Nigerian lecturer in economics of Yoruba culture. Sade also has an older brother named Benji. Her parents met in London and they married in 1955, and then they moved to Nigeria. Unfortunately, the marriage between Adebasi and Annie was short-lived, and at the age of 4 years old, Sade, her mother and brother, would move to England. While growing up in England, Sade listened to a lot of American soul music, getting influences from Curtis Mayfield, Donny Hathaway, and also Bill Weathers. Moving into her teenage years, Sade graduated from Clacton High School in Essex, England. With also getting an education at Colchester Institute at the age of 18, she moved to London to study fashion at St. Martin's School of Art. After completing 3 years of school, Sade would take up modeling briefly and also bartending. She happened to see the Jackson 5 performing at the Rainbow Theatre in London and seeing how they moved the crowd, and thought maybe one day she would be able to do that too. around the early 1980s, Sade would begin singing backup for a British band called Pride. Just so happened, Stewart, both of the Pauls, and Andrew were a part of this band, and this is how they met.
The way I got into singing was by chance. You know, somebody asked me to if I could sing. A friend of mine had a group and that had two backing vocalists. One of the singers left and they had a concert coming up, and he asked me if I could sing, so I said, oh, I'll attempt to. And so I auditioned for the band. They initially turned me down and then came crawling back to me when they couldn't find anybody better. They came back, and so I humbly and modestly accepted the position in the band.
Although they were still part of the band Pride, they began doing their own sets, performing the song Smooth Operator, co-written by Ray St. John. Sade was an unofficial band in 1982. Upon leaving the band Pride, the four members made their own band, Sade, official in 1983. The band Sade was extremely underground at first, but also popular, with having their first performance as a band at a club called Heaven in London's nightclub scene. With having a successful first show, thousands of people would have to be turned away. In May of 1983, the band would have their first US performance at a New York City nightclub called Dancerita. Around 1983, October, Sade would sign her first record deal with Epic Records, and the rest of the band would sign their deal in 1984. After joining Epic as a collective, the band would record their first debut album called Diamond Life. It actually took them about 6 weeks to record this album. Diamond Life will come out in the UK on July 16, 1984. With selling over 1.2 million copies in the UK and reaching number 2 on the UK charts. Diamond Life didn't come out in the US until February 27, 1985. It was a commercial success, peaking at number 5 on the Billboard 200s, and by May of 1985, Diamond Life would sell over 1 million copies internationally and 4 million copies worldwide. As of February 2nd, 1995, this album has went quadruple platinum, and as of November 1997, this album stands at 10 million albums sold. As of July 2020, Diamond Life has taken the crown with a stunning 21.45 million albums sold, making this one of the highest debuts in Sade's career. Diamond Life will have heavy hitter tracks such as Smooth Operator, Hang On To Your Love, which is one of my favorites, and also Your Love Is King.
Competition comes from inside us, you know, the competition with ourselves, and to try and get better and want to get better, it comes from inside, so it isn't a pressure from outside, really.
The group's second critically acclaimed album, Promise, came out November 4th, 1985, debuting at number 1 on the Billboard US charts and also number 1 on the UK charts. This album would eventually go 4 times platinum, spending 2 weeks at the charts in 1986, while selling over 4 million copies. I believe this is when the US would start to take the band serious. They will also win a Grammy for Best New Artist in 1986. By the year 1997, Promise would be certified quadruple platinum. With Promise being a beautiful album, it had notable tracks such as Never As Good As The First Time, Is It A Crime, and also one of the biggest hits off the album, The Sweetest Taboo. The band was on fire in the 80s, getting nominated for 2 MTV Music Awards for Best Female Video and New Artist for the song Sweetest Taboo. In July of 1985, the band would perform at the Live Aid concert in Wembley Stadium in London. This would make Sade the first African-born artist to perform in front of a crowd of 75,000 people, with the estimate of 1.4 billion people watching on television in 170 countries. The band would take a hiatus due to touring for 8 months from the Promise Tour from 1985 to 1986. They would come out with their third studio album, Stronger Than Pride, on May 3rd, 1988. Heading in a new direction with the music, this album would debut at number 3 on the charts and will also sell over 2 million albums on its debut. In the US, this album would go 3 times platinum, and also in the UK, it would go platinum as well. In France, it would go 2 times platinum. This album was overflowing with great vibes, making you feel like you were riding down PCH or walking down the beach in Hawaii. It had tracks like Nothing Can Come Between Us. It also had Paradise on here, and always the beautiful song, Love Is Stronger Than Pride.
She had actually retreated to the studio to concentrate on her third album, Stronger Than Pride.
Simple. There's less. It's less embellished, and I don't think that the themes are particularly different. They're about people and about life, and I don't think that'll ever change, as far as we're concerned.
Sade is serious about her music, and music lovers are serious about her, to the tune of 20 million records sold worldwide. And these days, there practically seems to be a Sade fan on every street corner.
A cold day in winter, and I put on a sort of a Russian fur hat with ear flaps, and I mean, I was totally disguised. All you could see were my eyes, more or less, and my nose. And I went to the shop and said, could I have, you know, some bananas, please? And the man behind the counter, he was about 50, so he wasn't the sort of person I would have expected to recognize me. He said, Sade, you know, you have what you want, you know.
Sade's latest album, which we mentioned, Stronger Than Pride, has already gone platinum. It's number 34 on the Billboard charts after 19 weeks.
The band would take their second hiatus after the Stronger Than Pride tour in 1988. Sade would get married to her boyfriend Carlos Pliego, a Spanish director, in 1989. Unfortunately, the marriage between Sade and Carlos would end in divorce in 1995. I think dealing with the immense pressure of fame and also having to make incredible music with that pressure and constantly being hounded by paparazzi, I feel as though Sade just genuinely wanted to be left alone. I think part of the reason why Sade always disappeared so often was to decompress from being underneath the limelight. You never really seen her at BET Awards or at the Grammys like that, because she is living in her peace. She never really wanted to be in the limelight like that. It was always about making music. And like I said, everyone does not want to be famous. It's more so about getting the music out there and being appreciative of the art. This woman is like a magician if you really think about it. She makes her music, she makes her money, and she stays in her lane and she gets out of the way. She knows how to spin the narrative in her favor to make the media seem as though they have no idea what they're talking about. And that is a wonderful thing to have your head on your shoulders in this music industry. She has been in this game for over 40 years and has accomplished so much within her career. The band would finally come out of hiatus, dropping its fourth album, Love Deluxe, on October 26, 1992. This album would peak at number 3 on the US Billboard charts, also selling 3.4 million records in the US alone, also going number 1 in France, New Zealand, Sweden, Switzerland, and the UK. Love Deluxe would be the band's second highest selling album as of July 2020. This album has sold over 15.25 million albums. Sade, the band, would win a Grammy in 1994 for Best R&B Group, performed by a duo or a group with vocals for the song No Ordinary Love. Love Deluxe is one of those albums where you can just pop it in and just ride. Even though it's only 9 songs on there, all 9 of those songs give you a punch, kick, or two, right, circle, circle, right in the gut to make you feel, cry, and invoke those emotions that you have not dealt with. With a listening time of 45 minutes and 47 seconds, you will be so surprised how fast these songs will go, and you will be finding yourself playing them over and over and over again. I've been telling you that music is frequency, and it has the ability to invoke certain emotions inside of you. Most notable tracks from this album is No Ordinary Love.
In the background playing right now, you have the single Kiss of Life. Follow up behind that, we have the song Feel No Pain and the most popular song Cherish the Day. Ruling the way.
Must have been an angel by my side. Something heavenly led me to you. Look at the sky, it's the color of love.
After the Love Deluxe tour wrapped in late 1993, Sade decided to take a break from music. She would briefly move to the Caribbean to live with a Jamaican producer by the name of Bob Morgan in the late 1990s. On July 21, 1996, Sade would give birth to her first child. Sade's daughter was born female and has made the transition into a man and goes by the name of Isaac Adu. In the year 2016, Isaac did come out online to tell everyone that he is a trans man, always giving his mom praises for helping him and supporting him through his transition. Sade has been with her partner, a former Royal Marine, since 2007. She also has a stepson. Unfortunately, I cannot find any pictures of her and Ian together, but just know that she is very much so taken care of. After an 8-year hiatus, the band released their 5th album, Lovers Rock, on November 13, 2000. This album would reach number 18 on the UK charts and number 3 on the US Billboard 200 and would go 3 times platinum. Lovers Rock would win a Grammy on February 27, 2002, and this would be the Grammy for Best Pop Vocal Album. The leading track that came off this album was By Your Side. This song was everywhere in the early 2000s, and it's a beautiful song to walk down the aisle to. The second single that came off this album is called King of Sorrow. The band would embark on their 5th tour, the Lovers Rock Tour, which started on April 2001, and it has become the 13th highest tour in North America, earning over $26 million.
This time around, the band took a decade hiatus, reuniting back in 2008, but releasing their 6th album in 2010 on February 5th. This album would be called Soldier of Love, and it debuted at number 4 on the UK charts and number 1 on the Billboard Top 200s, with first week sales at 500,000 copies in the US. Soldier of Love would win a Grammy in 2011 for Best R&B Performance by Duo or Group. This has been the 4th Grammy that the band Sade would win after being nominated for 9 Grammys. The most popular tracks on this album would be Soldier of Love and also Baby Father. Sade the band will go on its 6th tour called Once in a Lifetime Tour, starting on April 29, 2011 and ending on December 16, 2011. This tour will gross over $50 million. Sade the band and Sade the singer are legendary people, especially Sade herself. She broke down so many barriers, especially with her raspy baritone voice, her fashion statements, and she has influenced people such as Erykah Badu, Aaliyah, Beyonce, Nipsey Hussle, Kanye West, just to name a few. Her aesthetic and her beauty will always live on, and Miss Sade Adu, this video is dedicated to you. And this concludes the video of Miss Sade. And of course, I'm gonna give you a couple of my favorite tracks.
This may come as some surprise, but I miss you. I can see through all of your lies, but still I miss you.
She probably had less than every one of us. But when she knew how to walk, she knew how to bring the house down.
Sade, but here in the U.S., it's Black History Month. So for you to go do, you know, Jimmy Kimmel show and not do my show, that looks really bad.
My boy's from Harlem.
Okay,
my
all right, podcast well, boy. Okay, that tops me. Now the shoes. When did you start wearing shoes?
Well, it's a new thing. Do you like it? Not so much. Anyway, must go.
Okay, but look, Sade, please. Come on, Sade, please. Just one song. That's all I ask. Just one song. Something from your new album.
Something. Soldier of Love.
No, not that.
Be that easy.
No.
I'm off.
Wait, something years. From the next album. Yes, I'm saying I can't wait 10 years. I'm at the hinterland of my good days, Sade.